You've decided that you want to tackle spray foam by yourself, and you've got a nice little can of it right here to get the job done. I'm here to tell you, though, this may not turn out the way that you think it's going to, and I'm going to show you all the ways how. As you can see here, I have this nice and handy open cavity that I'm going to spray this foam into. Now, first things first, you have to follow the directions precisely to make sure that it's mixed the way that you want it to for the can foam. Froth packs are a little bit different because they're bigger, but for this video, we're talking specifically about small projects and can foam. With some behind the scenes movie magic, I've put on my safety goggles. I've also prepared this can of spray foam. I shook it vigorously per the directions, and I hooked up the little nozzle. This can also says for me to wear gloves, but I'm not going to, and you'll know why later. So let's start spraying and see what happens. I have this nice big cavity here. It's nice and open. We're going to assume this is something like your rim joist. So, what we're going to talk about right now is overspray. I don't know if you noticed, but we did get some overspray here on the sides. We had stuff that fell onto the ground, and that's going to be normal with a can like this, especially if you don't know how to spray it. It might be a lot of things, and I'm real smart, and I'm your brainiac, but I've never sprayed foam a day in my life, as you can tell from my application. So, as you can see, this is not the prettiest spray foam job in the world, but that's okay, because we're just doing this together as a DIY project. This is perfect for small projects, like I said, something like your rim joist. You are absolutely not going to want to buy a can of this and attempt to do all of your walls or your attic. We got this overspray here. We got some on the ground. This is why it's gonna be super important to make sure that you put down plastic on the ground, that you cover any windows, anything that you don't want spray foam to get on, you're gonna wanna cover up because this will get everywhere, especially if you're not familiar with how to spray it. So as you can see, you're going to get a lot of splatter as you're spraying. You're going to see splattering here, and you're going to see some more splattering right down here. This does not come out in a nice, smooth way. It comes out chunky. This is how it looks after you spray it. And this is almost an entire can, and I still haven't put enough in to create an air seal. So that tells me you're gonna need a lot of cans if you plan on doing your rim joist or something like that. So another thing that you could run into is that it's not going to adhere properly to the area where you're trying to spray it. If you haven't cleaned properly first, or there's any kind of debris or anything like that in the cavity, the spray foam's not gonna stick the way that you want it to, which means it could pull away from the stud cavity, or it could literally just kind of slip down. Another issue you could run into is that you don't mix the product properly. Now, in a can, you might think that there's not a lot of mixture that goes on, but there actually is. Each one has specific directions. With this one in particular, I had to vigorously shake the can for 20 to 30 seconds before I attached this nozzle. Had I not done that, the product would not have been mixed properly and it would not stick to the frame. Not all canned spray foam is created equal. You're going to get what you pay for. And I mean, essentially, you're going to have to pay for a lot of it to get the kind of coverage that you need to create an air seal. Now, some of it might be better than others. It's important for you to do your research first if you do plan to tackle this as a do-it-yourself project. Go with what people say works the best for them and try it out yourself, but maybe just buy one can first to give it a good test before you commit to buying all the cans that you'll need to fully cover the area that you're working with. Now, as I said, I happen to have this nice large open cavity here that I was spraying foam in. This is the amount that I was able to spray before I ran out. If you were going to do your entire rim joist, you'd want to buy a lot more, essentially, just depending on the amount that it will cover. This particular can says that it covers 11 square feet. So you would have to figure out and do a little bit of math to figure out what would work for your project. Another thing that I'd like to point out, when I said that this stuff is messy, it absolutely is. I have it on my hands, and watch our next video to see how I plan to get it off my hands. If you're interested in finding a RetroFoam dealer who also offers spray foam so that you can avoid making a huge mess, or having to spend a ton of money on wasted product, check out the dealer finder on our website. You'll find all these RetroFoam dealers who may also offer spray foam to save you from a headache. I'm your building science brainiac, reminding you to bring a little science to every project.